speak the wisdom of God only. Speak the wisdom of God only. Speak the, say it with me, speak the wisdom of God only. We're going to start at verse 1. I'm going to let you sit down. Read, David.
And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech,
came not with intelligent words to impress you,
read, or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of God.
The testimony of God is very important in our life. And let me tell you this, my brothers and sisters, the enemy want to rob you of your testimony. But you got to keep your testimony on your lips. The more you tell about what God is doing, the more he will do. Look at your name and say, come in agreement with the wisdom of God. Watch this, read.
For I determined not to know anything among you.
I'm not trying to find out nothing about you. Because it's not about you. Read.
Save
Jesus Christ. Read.
And him crucified.
And him crucified. The power of the cross. The power of the blood. Hey, that's amazing. I don't sit down and ask the choir what they gonna sing. But just by being in a Holy Ghost filled church, it's always lined up with what? They talked about the blood. This scripture just said, save Jesus Christ and him what?
Crucified.
What happened at the crucifixion? He shed his blood. Read.
And I was with you in weakness and
Paul said, I was with you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. Watch this, read.
And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom.
Can I go back up to the third verse, David? Because God is, you know, God ain't gonna always send you to places that you want to go. Sometimes you're gonna go in some place and God gonna tell you, say something, and your knees gonna buckle. God sent me places, ask my wife, God will send me places to preach to guys who just got out of prison, matter of fact, a penitentiary. I preached it one time and a guy cried out demonically because I preached a message, there's nothing hidden that shall not be revealed. And I started speaking on the things that was happening. And I said, folks come here and you praising God, but you go home and call your wife something different and beating your family. And that dude hollered out.
Wow.
I thought he wanted to attack me. But guess what? I just stood bold and kept preaching.
Amen.
And can I just testify?
Yes.
Then the first verse said, testimony
yes.
of God.
Yes.
I kept preaching. And I said, I'll be back tomorrow, same time, same bat channel.
Yes, sir.
Huh? I came back that day, 15 folks got baptized in the Holy Ghost. Speaking of the man who wanted to attack me came up to me and said, Bishop, I'm going to tell you why I want to attack you. I came in here deceiving everybody, and you uncovered everything I was doing. He received the baptism of the Holy Ghost that night, the second night. He said, I don't want nobody praying for me but this man. And so after service, the pastor said, Bishop, do you have time to, a guy want to talk to you. This guy said, another guy came and said, Bishop, I was going to go home last night, kill my family, and commit suicide. He said, but you came in here preaching like that. I had to live another day to see what you had to say. Now, I'm talking about God. You got to go in places that everybody ain't applauding you, but you got to speak bold what God said. And that's why it's important that you pray.
Yes. Lord.
You don't know what the price of the ministry. You really don't. I've been doing this since I was 21 years old. Got death threats on my life. But guess what? They didn't know I died in 1984. I died in 1984. My life is not my own. Look at your neighbor and say, die.
Die.
To yourself.
To yourself.
Die to yourself. You know why folk run from church to church offended? Because you ain't dead. I've been hurt by the church. You wimpy. You've been hurt at home. Did you leave? Watch this. See, I'm not one of them preachers that just massage your illness, your sickness, your weakness. Somebody got to tell you, stand up and be strong in the Lord and in the power of this mic. Are y'all right? I'm talking about speaking the wisdom of God. Now watch this. Read, David.
Verse 3, and I was with you in weakness.
I was with you in weakness.
And in fear.
And in fear.
And in much trembling.
And in much trembling.
And my speech.
And my speech.
And my preaching.
And my preaching.
Was not with enticing words of man's wisdom.
Uh-huh.
But in demonstration of the Spirit and of power.
You know what I love about this church? We ain't just talking. Every week somebody leave with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Power! Watch this. Read.
That your faith should not stand in the wisdom of man.
Should not stand in the wisdom of man.
But
you got to understand the people Paul was talking to. The Greeks was very philosophers. And the Jews always was looking for a sign. You know how you pray them prayers, Lord, show me. Let two cars drive by. She said, the only sign you're going to see is the sign of Jonah in the belly of the whale 3 days. God don't want you acting for a sign. He asking for you to walk by faith and not by sight. Read the book.
That your faith should not stand
in a man, in people. Find out the word of God. Get the word of God. Folks that really walking in the Spirit, when you come in this door, I ain't giving you nothing new. It's confirming what God been talking to you. Watch this now. That your faith should not stand in the wisdom of man, the philosophy of man. That's why I'm telling y'all, stop writing this stuff that people repeat over Facebook and it ain't the word. Anything makes sense don't make faith. See, this don't make sense for somebody to do you wrong and you still love them. That don't make sense.
All right, man.
That's why God don't want you to. Well, he gave you 5 cents. He ain't give you 5 cents to walk in here with. Gave you 5 cents so you could see, hear, eat, smell. But when you walk with God, stuff ain't going to make sense. It don't make sense. Give and it shall be given to you. That ain't what they taught us. Put up for a rainy day.
Yeah, yeah.
We've been raining all in our lives. Tried out the word of God. And it rained on the just as well as the unjust. But God said, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, running over. And that's not just talking about money.
Right.
Some of y'all need to give some forgiveness.
Right.
So you can be forgiven.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm about to preach in a minute. Watch this. Read.
But in the power of God.
Of God. Your trust gonna have to be in the power of God. That's why I don't run to every hospital visit no more. I teach you faith in God, then I send a hospital committee. I had to go to a wake. I sent one of my preachers to another wake. The person asked, why Bishop didn't come? What? I'm not Jesus. That's why we do team ministry in here. Ain't no superstar. It's all about Jesus. that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. And this is the reason your faith should stand in the wisdom of man. It's a way that seemeth to be right to a man, but the end of is the ways of death. That's why I don't, listen, when I'm reading an article and somebody say, well, in my opinion, I close the book.
Amen.
So I don't want your opinion.
Amen.
Give me what God said. If you write biblical things, tell me what God said. Don't tell me what you think.
Amen.
Or your opinion.
Amen.
How many folk dying because they living out folk opinion? Even your own opinion, if it don't match the word. Are y'all right?
Yeah.
Are you standing too long?
No.
I got to stand. Keep standing. Yeah, I don't like that preacher. Watch this. Read the book.
Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect.
Uh-huh.
Yet not the
wisdom. You got to speak wisdom among them that can handle mature. Mm-hmm. Not them drinking milk. A lot of people drinking milk and think you on meat. But if you don't get the milk and just skip, how you gonna get saved and skip to Revelation? You just got saved, now you bring the book of Revelation. I mean, we speak wisdom among them that are mature, yet not the wisdom of this world. Read.
Nor of the princes of this world,
mm-hmm,
that come to naught.
Yeah.
But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery.
We speak the wisdom of God in a secret. Watch this, read.
Even the hidden wisdom, which God ordained before the world unto our glory.
You may be seated.
Which none of the princes of this world,
if they knew who Jesus really was, read.
For they had not known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
Read.
But as it is written,
this is what I'm trying to get. But as it is written. Huh? I don't care what spirit speak to you, if it's not in line with what is written, it's not God. That's why I correct folks when they say, the spirit told me. What spirit? Demon? Your spirit? Holy Ghost? What spirit are speaking? You can't go off every voice. Got to line up with the word. Read.
Eyes have not seen.
Read.
Nor ear heard. Neither have entered into the heart of man.
Uh-huh.
The things which God has prepared for them that love him.
Let me tell you something. God has some things prepared for them that love him.
Amen.
How do you know if you love him? You do what he says. You do what he said. Jesus said, if you love me, you keep my word. You keep my commandment. Watch this, read.
But God hath revealed them unto us by his spirit.
That's why it's so important to have his spirit. You can have the letter, but if you don't have the spirit, the letter kill it, but the spirit bring life. We living in a day that folk telling you under grace. Yeah. By grace are we saved through faith, not of ourselves, but it's the gift of God. But you think God threw away the law? God didn't throw away the law. He said, I came to make it complete. Huh? So if the law don't mean nothing, why you ain't can't commit adultery? Why you shouldn't steal? The law was never bad. We just couldn't keep it. The law of God never been bad. But the wisdom of God said, I got to give you some grace, some help, so you can be able to do what I tell you. God didn't give you liberty to do what you want to. He gave you liberty to have the ability to do what he tells us to do. Give God a hand clap. You didn't get that. You didn't get that. It's going to come to you. The Bible said, eyes have not seen. Read, David.
Nor ear heard,
nor ear heard,
neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God. God has prepared for them that
and come. What God has prepared for you, don't reject. Speak the wisdom of God. God has things for you, but not just for you. He's concerned about somebody else too. When he called Abraham, he said, Abraham, I'm going to give you a good name. Abraham, I'm going to change your name to Abraham. You're a father of many nations. He said, I'm going to bless you that you may be a blessing. And all nations shall be blessed because of you. He said, I bless them that bless you. And I curse him that curse you. Saints of God, I'm trying to let you know, get in a place with God that you love him so you ain't seeking this, that, or the other, but you seeking ye first the kingdom of God. Keep God in his right perspective and all this stuff shall be added unto you. But don't go after the stuff, go after him. But at the same time, know that Daddy got some good things for you because you love him. Read, David.
But God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit.
But that's why it's so important to have the Holy Ghost. You can't walk this in your own strength. You can't get the revelation that I'm talking about in your own intellect and your own knowledge. God supersedes what you think. He said, listen, I'm able to do above all that you even ask or think according to the power that worketh in you. You don't know the treasure you have in you. Look at your name and say, yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, he loved me and I love him.
Yeah.
Nobody shouldn't have a problem if do God love you. Are we loving him back?
Yeah.
Because eyes haven't seen, nor ears heard, the things I have for them that love me. Huh? God knows when a man loves him. Watch this, read.
For the Spirit searcheth all things.
For the Spirit searcheth all things. Read.
Yea, the deep things of God.
The deep things of God. A lot of people want the deep things of God, but you can't handle the shallow things. What you want deep in God trying to give you shallow? Knowledge puffs up, but love edifies. You remember I tell you all, now listen to me now. You got to speak the wisdom of God. You got to stay in line with God. But guess what? Folks are trying to be public success, but they're private failures. Mighty man of God. Mighty man of God. But why your might can't make your house run? You perform miracles, but you can't perform a miracle on yourself. Oh. Watch this. David, go to, now remember, I want you to stay on this night verse because this is where I'm going to pull up all this I'm going to give you from. And I don't have much time, but watch this. But as it is written, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither have it entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared. Prepared for them that what?
Love him.
Them that love him. Watch this. Let me show you some things God has prepared for you. Go to the book of Isaiah 1, David. Isaiah 1, verse 19.
Amen.
Then you know I always got to balance this out to let you know why some stuff that God got for you, you ain't getting. You hear Isaiah?
Yes, sir.
Read the book. Start at verse 18, David.
Come now and let us reason together.
Come on, let's commune. Let's talk. That's why I love that girl testimony. She had a relationship because she just talked to God.
Yeah.
Remind me of my daughter Whitney, how Whitney just used to just talk to God. She'd come ask me something, I'd say, go ask your Heavenly Father. And she'd just go talk to him. Huh? Yeah, yeah. Watch this. Read, David.
Saith the Lord,
Though
your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow.
That's about that blood they sung about. I don't care how much sin you got, God's blood can cleanse it. And if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive you and to clean you up from all unrighteousness. That's why I don't understand how you not winning in God and He on your side. He on your side. He galling against you. He pulling for you. When you win, it bring glory to Him. Wow, that made me think about something I must show you. Watch this, read.
Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool.
Watch this, read.
If ye be willing and obedient.
Look at this verse. It says, if. Well, somebody prophesied to me, and it must come from God because it didn't come to pass. Some prophecy is on condition. You can walk right out the will of God and miss what He had for you. If ye be what?
Willing.
Willing deals with your attitude, your spirit. I can make somebody take out the trash. I'm talking about my children. But that don't mean they was willing. Take out the trash, boy. That ain't willing. But God said, if mean on condition.
Yeah.
If you be what?
Willing.
Willing and what?
Obedient.
God.